Hello guys, welcome to another LabVIEW video tutorial in which we are going to discuss about the clusters. So clusters are another data storage in LabVIEW where we can use different elements of mixed data types. Unlike the arrays where all the data types of the stored element should be the same, but in clusters it's not like that. So let's go back to the parking analogy where we were saying like all the data type should be the same in terms of array, but we can take that analogy in the terms of cluster, that the cluster is a glove box which is stored in one of those cars. So which contains a torchlight, a gauge pressure meter, or we can say the driver manual, or even the pair of gloves. So let's go back into the LabVIEW and let's see how it works. Okay, to add a cluster into the LabVIEW is pretty similar as we were adding the arrays. So what we can do is we can right click anywhere into the front panel, and then we can go into the containers, and then here you can see in front of the array we have a cluster. So I want to select a cluster, and then I want to click anywhere into front panel, and then I can add my cluster into front panel. And if I want to expand it, I just need to click on that, and then you would see there are a lot of blue dots are appeared. So you can just hold any black dot and then you can expand your cluster. And now I already have different controls. I have an array, I have a control, I have a string control, I have a numeric control. So I want to drag all these things into my cluster. So what I can do is I can just drag one by one. But there is a thing which you just need to notice, like in that arrays, like whenever we were dragging any element or any data type into the array, it was just shrinking to that element. But in the terms of cluster, it's not like that. It's still like that. And what you can do is you can drag as much as different elements you want to add in. Okay, suppose I added two elements, and before that I had the whole array and the control, or the icons were appearing separately. But as soon as I am dragging these elements in the clusters, so they are gonna be added into the clusters. Right now I have a device name here which is a string control. So if I want to drag it, so this is also included into the cluster. So this cluster icon is gonna represent all three values. Sorry for distraction, but if you think my videos are helpful for you, or if you are a serious LabVIEW learner, then I am gonna highly recommend you can go into the description of this video, and then you can find a course link where I have over 5 hours of video where I explain each and every tool in very detailed and with an example as well. And if you have any ideas about collaborations, if you have some projects or assignments, any task, feel free to write me in my email, which is also in the description of this video. Thank you. Okay, so to use the cluster, what I can do is I can just right click anywhere into the block diagram, and then I can go into the clusters, and there are a lot of different functions which we can use to use the cluster. The most important one I would say is bundle or unbundle. So right now we bundled all those values, so I would like to use the unbundle function here. And then if I'm gonna connect this cluster to my unbundle function, so you can see it is automatically expanded to three different outputs because we had three different elements into our cluster. Now what I want to do is I can just provide these values by using these nodes to other VIs or other indicators. But right now what I want is I just want to use the upper node, and I want to create an indicator here. And I can create an indicator, and the upper node is gonna give me the value of this element. So what I can do is I can just drag it here somewhere. So this was one option. I can have different indicator for every node. Or there is another option. I can go back into the clusters, and there is some other functions like unbundle by name. So suppose if I don't want to unbundle all the elements, so what I can do is I can unbundle by the name as well. So I can use this function. What I need to do is I just need to provide the input of this cluster to unbundle by name. So right now it's providing only the samples. So if I want to switch between the names, so what I can do is I can just bring my cursor, and then I can switch between the names. Suppose I want to see only device name. So in this way, it's gonna change to device name, or I want to see the sample rate. So in this way, I don't need to unbundle all the elements. So I can just unbundle by the name. So let's go back into the clusters and look at that. We can just bundle by names as well. We can build cluster array, cluster to array. There are multiple functions which you can explore, or even we can use in upcoming videos. And if you are not sure about any function, so what you can do is you can just drag that function into block diagram, and then you can press Ctrl H and you can open the help window. And then you can read, and they are gonna provide you all the explanation what this function does and how it works. So it could be really helpful to discover some new functions. That's all for this video. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please don't forget to like and subscribe to support this channel, where you are gonna find a lot of lab videos and tutorials. And if you are a serious LabVIEW learner, I am gonna highly recommend you can go into the description of this video and you can find my course link, where I have over 5 hours of LabVIEW videos in which I have explained each and every tool in a very detailed video with an example as well. And if you have some projects or assignments or tasks, feel free to write me on my email, which is also given in the description.